concert. On behalf of St. Paul's Lutheran Church and the Singing Saints, we are so glad that you are here for this evening. If the rehearsal that I heard earlier is any indication, you are in for a wonderful concert this evening. Just a couple of announcements before we begin the concert. First of all, right now is a great time to double check and make sure that your cell phone or other electronic device is turned off so that your ringtone does not join the beautiful sounds made by the Singing Saints. Also, after the concert this evening, you might take a few minutes, join us across the street in the grade school gym for a reception. Again, that's immediately following the concert tonight. Also, with your program this evening, you'll see a small sheet of paper with some save the dates for a couple of camps that are taking place this summer. So we hope you do exactly what that little piece of paper does, save those dates. There's more information about those upcoming camps that you will see in the weeks ahead. As we gather together and begin this concert together this evening, we want to come before our Lord in prayer, and so I'd invite you to please pray with me as we gather. Almighty God, Heavenly Father, you are the giver of every good and perfect gift, and we thank you especially tonight for the gift of music. Through this evening's concert, O Lord, we pray that you lift our hearts and minds and voices to you in praise, giving thanks for all of your benefits, most especially the gift of Jesus Christ, our Savior. It's in his name that we pray. Amen.
Praise God from whose heart. these souls, how fast you will go and leave me far behind. Don't stay for me, for now I see the Lord is good and kind. Go on, go on, my soul says go, and I'll come after you. Though I'm behind, I feel inclined to sing Hosanna too.
God give you strength, your grace to run, and keep your footsteps
right. How
fast you will go, and thy soul slow, you are not out of sight.
When
you look to that world above, and all God's glory see, on that bright shore your journey o'er, then look you out for me. May I at length be one among you there. Then all together we shall meet, together we will sing, together we will praise our God and everlasting King.
Come home. Bless his holy name. So we're going to take a little break. The choir is going to rehydrate. They've been working really hard. When we set this date for our home concert, I didn't know that my boss and my two main colleagues were going to be in Florida. I'm not sure why that happened that way, but they are actually at a LEA conference. So I get to tell you a little bit about what we do here, but to make my job easier, I just thought I'd turn it off onto one of my students because that makes it easier for me. I will tell you a little bit about what we did on tour, but for now I'm going to turn it over to Josiah Federwitz. And he spoke quite a bit on tour as well to our audiences, and he's got some really powerful things, I think, to share with you.
Hi, my name is Josiah Federwitz, and I'm a senior at St. Paul, and I've been here all 4 years, and I have to say it is a blessing to be here, and it's definitely going to be sad graduating in May. I had a lot of fun on tour. It was our 50th choir tour anniversary, and it's going to go down in history as one of the big ones for me. COVID kind of ruined junior year, but we had a small tour, but nothing like the big one. I landed here at St. Paul because of a few things. First of all, I'm here because my parents are missionaries with Lutheran Bible Translators, and they are located in the Fine Arts Building, and they thought it was a good idea for us to come here and have a little bit of family away from our nuclear family. But also, it came about because we were going to be going to the school that my dad went to boarding school in Ivory Coast. But unfortunately, between the years that he graduated from there and present times, there was a civil war that happened and the school is no longer standing. So that's why I'm here. And we never know how God's going to work. And sometimes it's in ways that we don't see or don't think could happen. And don't get me wrong, war is terrible, and it gets frustrating and upsetting sometimes, but God has a way of working through those things to bring about good things that happen. I just want to tell you a few things that we did on tour that kind of had an impact on me and kind of led me to see how great God is. We, as Christians, have a big family, and there's a lot of different denominations. And while we may think that our denomination is better or greater than every denomination, that's not true. And we had a Baptist bus driver on our tour. We had a different denomination donate their bus for us to use. We are a Lutheran singing choir. We got to sing in a Catholic basilica down in Georgia. And then on our way back from Florida, we got to sing in Elvis Presley's home church, the one where he grew up. And that is an Assemblies of God church. And not only were we able to minister to Lutherans that were down in Florida and on our way down to Florida, but we were able to minister to tourists and many people who actually worked at the Elvis Presley Museum down in Tupelo. And it definitely opened my eyes to know that we're not just singing for fellow Christians in other churches. You don't know who's going to be affected by what you sing. And as we got closer to tour, Dr. Marsh told us, you never know who's going to be at your concerts, and you never know who wants to hear or who needs to hear what you have to say. And it even says in the Bible, where two or more are gathered in my name, there I will be. So it doesn't matter if there's a million people in a church or two people that are in a church. It's still our responsibility to give it our best and to show the love of Christ and to share the message that God's got everything in his control and he loved the world so much that he sent his one and only son to come and die for us. And that's what matters. So it doesn't matter if there's a lot of people at a concert or just five or six. What matters is that we share the love of Jesus and what he came and did for us. And I want to say thank you to all you guys for coming out and praising God with us and worshiping and taking the time. And St. Paul definitely has been a family. And even though we get to do a lot of mission work out on our tours, there's still a lot of mission work that happens here at St. Paul. The mission work at St. Paul is not just the singing saints. It's people who are called to be teachers. Maybe your mission is to work at the rummage sale, or work at the SOS sausage dinner, or come and support fans or the players as fans, and also to support us in prayer. And we all have different gifts and different abilities, and it might not be singing in front of a whole congregation, but everybody has a gift and a mission, and that's what we're called to do, is to use our gifts and our abilities for God. And I want to just say thank you to you guys for being a great family to me here at St. Paul. And at the end of the day, it's not about you, and it's not about me, or even about the choir. It's about God and what he sent his son here to do for us. So I just want to say, give God the glory.
Thanks, Joe. I don't know if there's really much else that I can say after that. I really appreciated Josiah Federwitz, his leadership and his presence at the school. And his sister was here last year. She graduated, and Joanna's going to be coming up next year, and he's got another brother in choir as well. There's so many people from all over the world that are at our school. And this year, you may or may not know this, but we have 26 different nationalities represented at our school. For people from all over the world, and I'm trying to give the spiel that Kent usually gives because he's got it all rattled off, and Clint as well. I don't have special charts and all of that, but I do know that there are 26 different nationalities, and at one point we had 12 or 13 in our choir. I think right now there are 11 or 12. It keeps changing because people join because they think it's really fun, and it is really fun. So I wanted to just draw your attention, in addition to thanking you for coming, to the fact that while we were on tour, we had a number of conversations about the situation that was going on in the Ukraine, and I'll speak to that a little bit later before one of our pieces. But as we had a number of conversations throughout the tour, we had a lot of students that really developed close relationships. We had an opportunity for some of our students from Central Europe to be able to share how personal this was that's going on over there with some of our day students who really, their lives really aren't affected at all by what's going on. We hear about things in the news, but really some of our students who are from especially Slovakia and Poland and Germany, their families are working with refugees, taking in refugees. Their churches are involved with helping with this great humanitarian crisis. And so, we had some discussions, and we kind of brought up the idea of, hey, you know, wouldn't it be a wonderful thing to give back our home offerings? This home concert's always a big deal. And so we decided, we talked about it in the choir council, and I put out the thought that we could give 100% of our offerings to this refugee crisis that we have. And without batting an eye, 100% of the kids unanimously said, yes, that's what we're going to do. So I was very thankful. Yeah. These are amazing kids. I can tell you things here that they don't know. I don't say to them very often, and some of you parents may know this, I don't tell them very often that they do a great job, but they really are a phenomenal choir. I push them very, very hard because that's my job, is to get the best out of them that they can possibly give. And it's exciting to watch them discover that they're able to do things that they didn't think that they could do. And so they really are amazing kids. Those of you who are parents of these singing saints, thank you for entrusting them to my dictatorship. I've been told that doctor means dictator. It doesn't actually, but sometimes. We had a really great time on tour. And so the tour, like Joe said, is not just about singing in front of people. It's about building the relationships, and the time that they spend together is so important. And I think through that time that they have together, they learn about Christ in a new way. They learn how their music affects people. When they stand up and sing in front of people and all of a sudden some tourist is crying and saying how blessed they were that they just happened to be there at that time, that's an incredible, powerful moment of teaching, for one thing, for our students, but also as the Holy Spirit works in the lives of these young people. So they are really wonderful, wonderful students, and I appreciate them very much. So please give generously. They are giving their best to move and let the Holy Spirit work through them. They are vessels. I tell them that a lot. They are vessels to share and proclaim God's word in song that hopefully moves you to give in ways that maybe you otherwise wouldn't be so inspired to do. So thank you in advance for your generosity. We're going to have offering plates at the end of the concert so that you have time to think about that through the course of the rest of the concert, and give as you leave. And we thank you again for that.
deep and solemn roar.
Passes swiftly on its way.
I'd again draw your attention to the translation in the program for the next piece. I spoke a little bit at intermission about some of the work that is being done in Central Europe on behalf of some of our Ukrainian refugees, and this piece is a prayer. The text is by Martin Luther, and there's a translation in your program, but there's also a version in the hymnal. I believe it's number 777 in the LSB. The choir is going to sing a setting that Mendelssohn set, and they will sing it in German. They know it's my favorite one. But we ask that you would join us in this prayer for peace. Some of our students here, their lives are really have been turned upside down as a result of this. We have I can't remember how many total. Would you please raise your hand if you are from a Central European country? Right. And we have some Slovakians whose parents, I know, where's Daniela? Raise your hand. Her father, she sent me a text 2 days ago, I think it was, and he's a pastor in Slovakia, a Lutheran pastor, and was on the border of the Ukraine going to feed and bring food and supplies to women and children who were refugees and spending some time praying with them. She sent me a text and said, please pray for my father, please pray for the refugees, but please pray that he will return safely. And she texted me today that he got back safe. So we are very thankful to God for that. And I think, Timotei, raise your hand. Your church is already hosting several refugees as well. This is very personal to a number of our students who are also, some of them, a little concerned about whether they're going to be able to go back this summer safely, or whether they stay here, or whether they go back, and what exactly happens. It's not clear. We know that there's much uncertainty, but what we are certain of is that, as Joe mentioned, God has got us in his hands. And so we sing this prayer for peace, this Verleih uns Frieden. God will fight for us. God alone will fight for us. And we pray for peace.
Thank you.
Seniors, could you please come down to the front? So it seems fitting that after a German song, I'm going to do what I've done since I started here, and that was a German tradition from my daughter's choir, and acknowledging our seniors with a card and a flower. And I don't do this very well with a microphone, so I'm going to have you take one. For your seniors, well, no, oh, just a second. Oh, these were tour seniors. Yeah, I'm sorry. yeah. Sorry, we had somebody join at the last minute as well, so sorry about that. Yeah, our seniors who are graduating from this last fall and are on the touring choir and who have put, a couple of you are four, how many of you are 4-year seniors? There's three or four, five, yeah. Okay. And then there's two of you who joined last year, and then three of you who joined. No. I'm mixing up. Okay, there's you six and you two. Okay, yeah. All right, and yeah, it's always complicated trying to remember who's done what. So Grace Hartwig is on the end, and Grace, I have something for you. And whoops, where is yours? I should just call you with which one is on the top, because yours is the very last one. There you go. It says Grace Hartwig, and she's in our soprano section. And Philip McCaslin. It actually happens to be Philip's birthday today. We forgot to sing happy birthday to him, but it's Philip's birthday today. Yep. Josiah Federwitz, as you heard, yeah, okay. Elijah Rankin, oop, there you are. Yeah. In case you didn't notice, he's got a beautiful voice. Cooper Ritzma, thank you. Bass. Adrian Martins, thank you. There you go. Thank you. And Dylan Parker, who is our choir president. Thank you. There you go. And Annika Ruskus, who is our choir vice president. Also my godchild from Germany. Yep. And while I'm up here, I'd also just like to mention that some of them who are seniors here and some of them who are also in the rest of the group competed yesterday in the district festival. We had 10 contestants and 9 of them are going to state. So that's pretty cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord look upon thee with favor and give thee peace. Amen.